relationship starts with a friendship and build.
First Timothy 1:5 says, "I'm all for Christians to be whole point. If by being here, opening your Bible, it's a weight. It's just stuff that actually gets in the way. Right? It's nothing like being in love and loving Jesus. When you're at that spot, what he asks us, weight to it, and it may have some heaviness to it, but we're willing to lift heavy things for those that we love. Those we love, we're willing to put up with weighty things. Like, don't do this, or do this, or talk to this person. Willing to go if we love and are in love. Love! I like this. Kind of explains love a little bit. 1:21 version is simply love. Love uncontaminated by self-interest. This we're talking about the high love now. The highest love, the real love. Uncontaminated by self-interest and counterfeit faith. What's a counterfeit faith? Oops. Yeah, I mean, there's all sorts of things that. What the church has done is put it's Jesus Christ plus other things. Once knowing Jesus as Jesus Christ, we put something else in the foundation. Those who fail to keep this point still look at offering the cul-de-sac. What's a cul-de-sac? Into these, where am I? Where am I? Where are? Eventually, we wake up in a cul. I think in a cul-de-sac. I hope you wake up. You sort of just say, "I gotta get out of here." Minnie and I were in Philadelphia one time, and we were out of gas coming home from this conference in downtown Philadelphia. We were coming home. I gotta get gas. I'm getting really low. I got off the freeway. This didn't look like the right area of Philadelphia that I should be looking for gas. I got caught up in some cul-de-sac there. And then I said, "I gotta get back on the highway. I don't think I can stop at the stop sign up here. I need to sort of roll through." People were hanging out on the outside, drinking this and that. I mean, it was like hanging out near where the road is, and just like, man, I gotta get out of here. I said, "I hope I have a little gas left." I mean, you just don't go off when it's on E. But every once in a while, you know, we're all human. We all of a sudden say, "Oh my goodness, I need." You know, in the cars these days, they have lights and bells and whatnot going off on you to tell you've got miles left or whatever. Well, not back then. I mean, it was like. Mm-hmm. So anyway, we got gas eventually, but I had to get off that road. I have no idea how to get, you know, sort of have to go back to where you got off to get out. Mm-hmm. Or else you're hoping, I mean, roads normally have something up ahead. I don't know how long it was going to be and where I was exactly going. The whole point of what we're urging is simply love. God, keep our relationship with you simple, with a simple focus. We sometimes bring all sorts of stuff in here, and we can't follow you. We've made it so weighty, so weird. Forgive us, God. Help us to come back to that simple love relationship. Relational rhythm and just breath. You see, to love God means that we keep His commands. And His commands don't weigh us down. Turn to your friends and say, God's commands will not weigh you down. It's not going to weigh me down. It's not going to weigh me down. Everything, say everything.
Everything.
Everything that has been fathered by God, that comes out of God, that God begins, overcomes the corrupt world. This is the victory that has conquered the world. It's that. Sure thing. Talked about that previous passage. I love Jesus. I'm in love with Jesus. Trust Jesus. Okay, so the commands can weigh us down when or if. Let's get that over loose again. Commands or the commands can weigh us down when or if. Have you ever felt weighed down by commands? Even, quote, religious commands? Maybe Bible commands? Weighed down? Okay, the commands can weigh us down when or if, let's get down a little room again.